Manu Bhaker shot excellently all through these Asian Games, but she could not finish her campaign with a medal. Manu is here with me along with Indian shooting legend and now national coach Jaspal Rana. You feel a bit strange now this competition's got over, that you've shot so well, but you don't have anything to show for it?
No, I'm feeling good. At least I got a good experience and I'm okay with that. Instead, I have gotten now I need to boost myself up and practice more and work harder. So it's sometimes good to fall down and then get up with more energy. So that's fine. That's totally good.
You're a very aggressive shooter. So when you shoot something like a 593, which is as close to the world record as is possible, which probably nobody in India has ever shot before, and then it doesn't translate, are you hard on yourself when you come back to your room?
No, I just thought that ups and downs will be going throughout my life, so I must try to handle myself more, with more I must give myself some space and not to think that much about those things. So just relax and sleep.
Okay. She sounds like you accept the sleep part.
No, I think she understood what is required right now, because winning and losing is part of a game, and you can't keep climbing all the time. You have to come down to the base camp. And if you are smart enough, you will come down with respect, and then you settle down yourself, get your energy together and get back again. And see, I never shot that score in my life in a competition. So I think it's anybody's dream to shoot that kind of score. 593 is not something which happens now and then just like that. So I think that score is quite good enough to be in the final in Olympic. She just have to make it into the Olympic by quota place. And I think it's a good preparation for the World Championship.
But for you as a coach, Jaspal, because you've been in these shoes, you know, you were a child prodigy yourself, so you know what kind of expectations they are. And then when you shoot that score, and then that deep within that regret. So as a coach, what have you been telling her, especially now that this campaign has ended? Is there any time to relax, or is it just forget it? Because you can do it after so many years. She's a young kid.
I've done it myself, because after 94, there was a big dip for almost 1 year, 2 years. So if I can handle that thing, and I could not handle that time because there was no one to tell me that time, because everybody has too much of expectation, and same expectation a father, parents, family has, even the country people have. But to be really honest, one will fall down, and if they are strong enough, mentally, physically, whatever, they will bounce back faster. And you must have seen Anis today. There's nothing wrong with the kid. There's something wrong which he's doing. There's nothing, I will say that the 100% is not there. So I expected him to be in the final today. But there was a little setback that the way he shot. So now I have to sit with a foreign coach and talk where are we wrong in that case? But with Manu, I can't say that there's anything wrong, because final is one shot game. You miss out on one shot, you do one little mistake, you're out. So that's what happened with her. And she was in the final in both events, and they missed the final with the same point in the mixed double. So they're almost there.
And when you talk about having a rise and a fall, that's wisdom beyond your years. What has his influence been? Every time I've seen you here, you've been with him, you've gone out for a run. How important is it to be disciplined, especially at this young age?
I think being disciplined throughout our life is very important, because being a junior, I've always been in the circle of discipline, and but it is important part of our life. I know that, and that's enough for me. So I just work hard, and he always tells me that don't expect too much from yourself. You will lose, you will win. You can make world records, or you will have to settle down with lowest scores. But keep yourself boosting up. So I think he's a great coach.
That we all know, he's a great shooter, now he's a great coach. But for you, considering the year you've had, you know, you've had a phenomenal year. It's one of the greatest starts to a career I have seen, like perhaps Zhu Qinan or young Hauran in 2014. So for you, the way you've approached this year, the way it started for you, and where you're going now to the World Championship, are you, in a sense, are you amazed at what you've achieved this year? The success you've got, and sustained success, not just one tournament and one shot wonder?
I didn't even thought of these things, like when I just shot in the nationals and then in the trials, and then I got to know that I have been selected for like senior competitions and World Cups. So I was, yes, I was amazed that I've been selected for Commonwealth, and I was very excited for that. Now it's like, yes, I've been selected, and I'll have to work more harder so that I can at least give myself an average level or that.
How do you manage the expectations? A lot of it falls on your shoulders. How do you manage the expectations around these young kids?
See, I don't have to manage that, because expectations, that's natural. Like, you know, people sitting in India...
No, I mean you expecting things from them.
No, I don't expect anything from them. I just want a good score. I just want them to give their best. Rest is destiny, because you can't decide, because they are individual sports. You can't do anything about somebody else. Like, she was a 8-point lead in sport pistol, so nobody can do anything about it. She will be in the final, right? But in the final, it's all destiny. It's so expecting too much from them, and see, they have gotten more than what we have asked. Like Anis, Manu, Saurav Chaudhary, they don't live normal child life, like, you know, teenagers' life. They don't have access to TV. They don't have access to phone. They can't eat what they want to eat. They can't talk to their friends. They can't talk to the family.
But hang on, that's because of you.
No, it's not because of it's required. Because, you know, until they don't get out of these things, they can't... We need more time to doing things which is required to do. So, I don't have a choice. I don't like it, but...
That's the mantra you followed in your career when you were an athlete. I just want to draw a larger context here. She's just 16. You had Lakshay, who won a medal at 17. You had Saurabh Chaudhary winning a gold at 16. You had the young Shardul winning a silver medal at 15. How do you explain this? Is it because they are more hungry, or because of the fact that they are perhaps much more disciplined, that they're being able to get these results, while the pressure of expectations is pulling the senior shooters down?
No. I don't think it's anybody's pulling anything down.
No, that's the pressure of expectations.
Expectation, why? Because if you don't do right thing, you will not get the right place. You need to do some few things, some basic things. If you have to fly down somewhere, you have to buy a ticket, right? To buy a ticket, you have to talk to a travel agent. Travel agent ko paisa doge. To aapko mehnat karni padegi, na system banana padega aapko. Tabhi to aap jaoge. And then when you travel, then you should know that ki kitna weight leke jana hai, kitne din wahan rehna hai, hotel karna nahi karna. If you don't plan, there's nothing in your future if you don't plan it properly. These kids, yes, it's a like 6-7 years program, like which we're doing for last 6-7 years. And I'm thankful to NRA and NRA president that who had a vision of doing this junior program. And today we are here because not 1 or 2 years hard work. It's been happening for a long time. Yes, these people also came like 2-3 years back. But 2-3 years back, we had everything in place. Once they're in the squad, there's a foreign coach, there's a armorer, there's a coach, and there's a system where we have to, where we get them in one place, get the grip mates, get the equipment fixed. So it's a lot of work. So what you see is a lot of teamwork.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of that happening at the range. If for one day, I know you're headed off to the World Championship now, but if for one day you were allowed to, you know, just forget shooting before you go to Korea, if you're allowed to just one day to yourself, what would you do?
Sleep.
Actually, I have many other hobbies, but I couldn't
continue
those. Like, I always wanted to... I'm very good at skating, but so I always wanted to do ice skating. So I never tried it because of shooting. So I just... But shooting is also my love. So I never thought, like, if one day is there for me, that I can do anything. So I never thought of it. But leaving that shooting... For one day, I could go for ice skating, I guess. I don't know, because I never thought of it.
Okay. She's young. We can allow her that. And perhaps, you know, the way things are happening, skating could soon be an Olympic sport. So you head off to the World Championships. Forget this. Move on. It's a new competition. You have a good old veteran of the sport with you. So it's a new start and all the best for that.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you very much.